At Kindig-It Design, we build all sorts of styles of cars in different eras. This is actually one of my very favorite muscle cars. This 1965 Pontiac GTO, a little bit off the beaten path, but certainly a classic.
Bitchin', I think it's really bitchin'.
You guys do such a nice job of the fit and finish on these things, but again, we haven't really lost what the car started as. I'm telling you, to do all of that work, it was such a nice payoff, wasn't it?
Well, yeah. All the stuff we did to these bumpers to get them so tight and just making all the lines work, it was a trick.
Well, here's what I always say, Will. If it was easy, everybody would have already done it, and then it wouldn't be cool. Sitting on an Art Morrison frame, we're using 19 and 20-inch billet specialty Fury wheels.
Hot wheels.
Right down 1965, you know? What I like the most about this car is the color scheme that we use between the contrast of the interior and the exterior, playing off of, like, browns. Who paints a car brown? And I think this will be a classic for a very long time.
I love the glass smooth firewall where you can, looks like two engines in there.
Yeah. This 480 horse LS3, and it's backed by a 4L65E transmission. So one of the funniest stories about this car, when we had it up in Puyallup and debuted it for Ron,
yeah,
a gal came by and says, "Oh, I love the interior." And then she walked to the engine and she goes, "Wow, they even wrapped the engine in leather?"
Yep.
I was like, all right,
I heard
now
that
I've heard
a
it
couple
all.
Times.
This thing sounds like $1 million. It's actually got a just killer rumble. So what's your favorite part about the car?
The gas pedal.
So let's go. I love this car, and I love the zoomies. Oh! Let's go. Hey, Dave, will you open the door? Hey, we should go rob a bank. And then as soon as the cops look, that wasn't me.
Wasn't me, officer.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Wasn't me.